find the polar form of the complex number, they given minus 2 comma minus 2y. So first you take z equal to given number minus 2 and minus 2y. What is the polar form? We want to find the value r cos theta plus I sin theta. So our aim is to find the value of r and theta. If you know the value of r and theta, substitute here. That is the polar form of the given complex number. So how to find r value? R equal to modulus of z. So modulus of z equal to square root of, what is the real value? Take as such the whole square. Then coefficient of item, the imaginary value whole square. That is equal to 4 plus 4. It become a root 8 will come. So root 8 we can write as 2 root 2. Now we want to find the alpha value. So I am not find theta value. First you find alpha value, then you go to theta value. You can able to find alpha value two way. First I explain one way, another next I will explain the second way also. First how to find the alpha value? Take the r and multiply with the real value. So take the r into cos theta. This is the real value here in polar form. Here what is the real value? Minus 2. Then we can write cos theta equal to minus 2 by minus 2 by r. Then what is the r value? 2 root 2. If you put eliminate, become a minus 1 by root 2. So cos theta equal to minus 1 by root 2. Same way find the sine term. So r sin theta. So imaginary value is equal to minus 2. So sin theta equal to minus 2 by r value. So minus 2 by 2 root 2. Then finally become a minus 1 by root 2. Now we want to select the angle. That should be satisfied both cos term also, sine term also. That means without symbol, we think, don't worry about this minus symbol. So sine theta also become 1 by root 2 will come. Then cos theta also 1 by root 2 will come. When I substitute instead of theta value, instead of substitute any one angle here, that should be give a 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. So both should be equal when the angle is pi by 4. Because sine pi by 4 also 1 by root 2. And cos pi by 4 also 1 by root 2. Sometimes it will be different value will come. Maybe here root 3 by 2. Don't worry about negative. We take as consider only the positive value. For example, maybe here cos. So cos 1 by 2 is there. When the cos 1 by 2 will come, sin 60 degrees will come. Cos theta equal to 1 by 2. Then sin theta equal to root 3 by 2. So you have to check both. So at what time the both values are equal, at what angle it gives 1 by 2 in cos, same value sin also give what, root 3 by 2. So like that you select the alpha, that is alpha equal to 60 degree, that means pi by 3. So cos pi by 3 equal to 1 by 2, sin pi by 3 is what, root 3 by 2. So likewise the alpha value should be satisfied both cos also sin also, like that you select the alpha value. Here we have 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. So we have come to conclusion alpha equal to pi by 4. Alpha equal to pi by 4. So alpha equal to pi by 4. Then I use the word, don't worry about negative. Now you can write theta lies. Now you take the negative. Theta lies in the third quadrant. With the help of the question, real value also negative, imaginary also negative. You can write like that, minus 2 comma minus 2. That means x comma y. So theta lies in the third quadrant. Why I mention in third quadrant? Please always remind that condition. First and second, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. In first quadrant, relation between theta and alpha. So theta equal to alpha. Here theta equal to minus alpha. Here theta equal to pi minus alpha. Here theta equal to alpha minus pi. This is important things to apply here after finding the alpha. Now only go to enter the theta. Now theta equal, theta lies in third quadrant. What is this here? Alpha minus pi. So theta equal, what is alpha? We have pi by 4 minus pi. It become cross multiply. So pi minus 4 pi by 4. Pi become a minus 3 by 4. This is theta. You know the value of r. You know the value of this is r. This we have theta. Substitute here. So take as equation 1. Then z equal to 2 root 2. Cos minus 3 by 4 plus I sin minus 3 by 4. You get the polar form. If you want write in a general term, you can add here 2 k pi. Same thing you can write like this also. So 2 root 2 cos 2 k pi minus 3 by 4 then plus I sin 2k by minus 3 by 4. So k is some integers. You can write another way also in the standard form of the polar form. Now I told how to find one more way, the alpha value. I will explain now the second way to find the alpha value. That's easy. Maybe which is easy for if you can follow any one method. But we need theta equal to, we don't apply the same way. Now directly you can write alpha equal to tan inverse of modulus of y by x. We can follow this condition also to find the alpha value. So alpha equal to tan inverse of y by x. Alpha equal to tan inverse of y by x. Then alpha equal to tan inverse of modulus. Remember, y value is minus 2, x also minus 2. Minus 2 by minus 2. Then it become alpha equal to tan inverse of 1. So tan inverse of 1 at tan 45 degrees 1. So tan 45 degree, tan pi by 4 is 1. Then pi by 4 equal to, you can write tan inverse of 1. So now come to conclusions, alpha equal to pi by 4. This you feel easy, it goes like that. So tan inverse, we know the tan principal value 0 to 90. Now alpha equal to pi by 4. Now we can use the word theta lies third quadrant. So what is the condition? Theta equal to alpha minus pi. Again theta equal to pi by 4 minus pi. Then theta equal to minus 3 pi by 4. Then z equal to 2 root 2. Substitute the value, r value and theta value. So cos minus 3 pi by 4 plus I sine minus 3 pi by 4. Sometimes use a shortcut also, they write like that 2 root 2. The first letter from cos C, then I, then first letter from sine, then write the angle minus 3 pi by 4. This way also sometimes they write the polar form.